Continue with the next topic. We would like to invite yang berbahagia Dr. Benedict Toppin, the Executive Secretary of the KDCA, to present his paper on the Sunduan, the Undung Adau.
Okay, I want to congratulate the organizers because I think it's about time. The last time I presented something along this line was I think almost 5 to 7 years ago. And I think it's very pertinent that all our participants for the Undung Adau especially, I was hopeful that they are around today, tonight. Where are they? Because then we can share some of those things. Because in my, when I prepared this, it was for them that I wanted to share about what is it, what are the thing, why are the, we call them Undung Adau, and what are the terminologies like. Okay, I want to mention a bit about the mystery first, because there are various terms that have been used. Before I go to the rationale why it is called the soul of Undung Adau. You see, we have a way of saying from the Rinites, from the ancient Rinites of the Bobohisan, they always have Wallace, we call, or synonyms. So like, for instance, Kinaingan is the same as Kopunon, is the same as Minamangun, and is the same as Manidong. That's why when the Bobohisan said Tinidong the Minamangun means created by Minamangun also. Okay? So Sumundu is the same as Humadun. Sumundu means has the capacity to perform miracles or miraculous in a way. Okay, Suminundu is the process of having transformed or miraculously transformed into something. So you can see all those relationship. We have the creator couple as the main deity head of the Karajan Dusun belief system of Mumalian. Kinoroingan, Kinoingan, and his wife Sumundu. And sometimes people mistake the, you know, Sumundu and Suminundu because they are almost synonym, but they are actually different. Sumundu is the mother. And whatever happens after that, the transformation, Suminundu is the miraculous transformative effect. In Pinampang, they also have it Penajivung, Penampuan. And they also have Hinokizan. Have you heard about that, Pinampang, you know, Fox? Hinokizan? You heard, huh? But the synonym of Hinokizan in the Rinite is Sambayoy. And it all means the same. And then you have Bambarayon, Bambazon, same as Teguruan, and it has all a relationship with Undung Adau. I will explain why the term Undung Adau is later on. Let me go first to the summary overview of the genesis and the cosmological flow, because we have to understand this if we want to see how Huminodun become the sacrificial redeemer for the entire Karajan Dusun community and the world. Okay, first, there was a creator couple, Kinaingan and Sumundu. And they had an only daughter, Penampuan. I'm using the Pinampang term Penampuan, who is all-time benevolent and became the redeemer daughter in the end. And there is another son, Penampulan. But he was the malevolent one. I have traced this in the beginning that, you know, there are not many, I wonder why it was not mentioned by many Bobohisan. It seems that there was a time the separation between this and all those believers of the Mamalianism because there was a curse. So Kinoingan became Tuminaru. Tuminaru means he instituted a kind of a curse to this particular son and banished him to go to the underworld, which is the creation of Penampulan himself. It was also mentioned in the Eastern Kadazan, it was mentioned by Hulbert Hope, a researcher from ISIL, is it? That there is a son of the deity, the Kinengan and Sumunuk. Why it is not mentioned? Because it is discouraged to mention this particular rebel son of a deity. So that's why it's never popularized. So what is popularized is Huminadun, Unduk Ngadau, Penempuan, and all those that are related to Unduk Ngadau for her benevolence. Okay, Kinengan and Sumundu created Libabow, the upper world, and the middle world, which is where we are living now. Remember, there are three levels of the world. Upper world, they call it Libabow. The central world is Winarun. Then the underworld is Kalungkun. But the Kalungkun is a creation of the sun, the rebel sun. Kinengan and Sumundu also created the Sunduans, the divine spirits, the Rusads that are on the earth. You see, the divine spirits in the Winarun. We have the Rusad for the animals, Rusad of the greeneries also. Both the flora and fauna, they have got Rusad. They are the spirits. That's why Padi also is spirited, and not ordinary spirit, but Huminadun herself. Then they also created the Kadayans. The word Kadayan, I use the word Kadayan because it is in the Rinite. It is not invented by anybody. It is as old as the Rinite, and if you want to date the Rinite, go ahead. I wouldn't know where it starts, but it is like our Ramayana and Mahabharata. And to me, Kadayan at one point in time was used popularly by the elders from Inanam onwards, right to Kota Belud, and then also from Beaufort, Klias to Tatana, and at the same time to those Kadayan in Sipitang. In Pinampang, in the Rinite also, is Kadazan. Okay? Z and is the same, Kadayan alias Kadazan. Kadayan in the Rinite is specifically a creation of God and spirited by divinity in humanity. Pinasunduano Diwato. This is very clear in the Rinite of the late Balungkitas Tan Tagas Runduman from Tagas Tuaran. I got those things from her. So I think we are lucky to have at least this sharing from them. Okay, then Penempuan and Penempulan were actually designated caretakers of Winarun. Kadayans were given to be Dusuns. I use the word Dusun here, taken from the Polynesian Malay word of gardeners in the forest. And it fits in because we are stewards of the land. Then there came that calamity of Kinagagaan, a rebellion in Libabow from Penampulan. At first, he was relegated to the fourth level of Libabow. There are so many levels of Libabow, of course, 7. But he continued to do his evil. So finally, he was banished from there and the entire Libabow, and he has to be dumped into his own creation of Kalungkun. So the story goes on, he became Regon Gaya, the chief of all, then Regon Gaya and Karagana, now all the cause of the Winarun and the Kadayan punya downfall. After the downfall, Kinarengan has to do some disciplining in order that he can gain back the creations, the humans who have strayed away can come back. So he ejected the 7 scourges. Have you heard about the 7 scourges? Okay. Let's see whether they are around here. I think no. Never mind. We continue first. The last of that 7 scourges, as a result of severe continuous drought, was seedlessness and exterminating famine. And for the redemption, Penempuan has to come to aid to be the redeemer. That is why Huminadun became the soul of Bambarayan to be in the seed of the paddy to give food to the Kadayans. Not ordinary food, but spiritual food. By and by, Huminadun, in commemorating her as the redeemer, became idolized in Unduk Ngadau, Kamatan. Thus, became the soul of Unduk Ngadau. So it has a relation. And if Unduk Ngadau, if Huminadun is the soul of Unduk Ngadau, and Unduk Ngadau is the highlight of Kamatan Festival, so Unduk Ngadau can be the soul of Kamatan Festival. And during Kamatan, actually there is a deeper meaning of Maginakande. The first tasting of rice is like comparable to the Christian Holy Communion, because the spirit of Huminadun in the newly harvested rice and the spirit of the person, the kaduduo, merge as one when they eat. And therefore, there is an element of cleansing oneself before you receive or before you host Kamatan Festival. And that's why we have the rituals, especially very much, practiced in Kota Belud still, called Memulangga. Memulangga, and then after that, Memulangga means to cleanse off not only the place where you are hosting the Kamatan, but also your own self and whoever is celebrating. They do this through night. Sometimes you may not be away, but they ask forgiveness on your behalf even. They mention everybody. They said, some of us may be naughty, but forgive them, for they may not know what they are doing. But they say, make peace. We want to pray that there will be a peaceful venue. There will be a peaceful interrelations between all those sharing this feast. Here we are. As the Kadayans, humans consume rice and drink rice wine, Huminadun in Bambarayan communes with the Kaduduo. Kaduduo is the divinity in humanity. I will call it like that. It is your accompaniment from God wherever you go while you are still on earth. In the story of epic story of the one in Tuaran, they call it is the Sampapas, your Sampapas. If you want to look for your Sampapas, I think you are only Sampapas if you are not completed without the Kaduduo, because the Kaduduo is part of you in the higher realms. So there is a beautiful story about it. So Kamatan Festival is a commemorative feast of Huminadun's greatest love and all idolized in Unduk Ngadau. For Huminadun gave of her life for the salvation of the Kadayans and the Winarun. So the Kadayans, in short for Kamatan, celebrate Rumamai, yeah? Lamai Kamatan. And they give praise and thanks. They used to menugandai even while Kamatan. Sugandai is a form of sing-song praise in honor of and thanksgiving for Kinengan for the harvest. So once again, just for, you know, I go to the Genesis, there is the Creator's omnipresence, Minamangun, Kiningan, and Semundu, and there is the creation, Libabo, Winarun, and all the Suang Winarun, and there is the fall of Penempulan, the fall of man and creation, and then the scourges, the seven scourges, war over the lost Tataba, Kaliandri, the plague, the rapid, we call, dispersion and migration, locusts, deluge, the drought, and finally the seedlessness and famine. So the concept of redemption came in because there was an exterminating famine. So Huminadun comes into the picture. Remember Huminadun, from Penempuan, Huminadun means transformed into many miraculous gifts of food, first of all, rice. After that, then there are the revelations where she started to teach all the Bobohizans, so the first Bobohizans and then the Bobohizans subsequently to that one, on a new belief system, which we call Momolian, Momolianism. And there, from the Momolianism, we got our adat and our culture. That's why we cannot mention in vain the name of our in-laws because of our respect in relation to Kinoyangan and Semundu, the deity couple. And so many other examples of how the spiritual values has been ingeniously put into our adat system. And then we have a unique way of life. And I term it Kadazan Nationology, the Tao of the Kadazan. And I want to share some of these things here. I don't know if you can see, it's too far away. Yeah? Okay, anyway. So the ultimate is here, the godliness. We are all origin from here, because from the intention of God, if he wants, then we can become. From here to humanity. From humanity, we have a capacity also to transform into many. One, we can become the greenery, we can become part of the plants, we can become animals, and then we can also go to Kolongkut, the cursed place in the underworld, but we can also become nothing. That is why in our adat, it is very, very, what they call, forbidden to curse Kausung Kana. You know, Kausung means may you become nothing. May you become void and things like that. It is punishable by adat. After that, then we go to, if we, because after death, some of us are half-baked or cannot directly go back. So we have to go to Pengeluan and the lowest rims of heaven and the highest of Mount Kinabalu. That is where you call Pengeluan. And it is, I cannot help but make it, you know, compare it to our purgatory. Because the Gimbarans there, see, Gimbaran, by the way, are the spirits of the ancestors or those people who are dead. But our Bobohizan can communicate with them and then ask them to help. Alternatively, they can come themselves to help those who deserve help. That's why sometimes maybe you have an accident and then there is a heavy car on top of you, but at the spur of the moment, you can overcome that because the Gimbaran comes and help you. Okay, here are the various levels of how the Renites have organized the upper world, middle world, and underworld. So you see, I put Mount Kinabalu there. The highest there is Pengeluan. You notice that the world itself, where we live in, are divided into the Gaunan, Panarakasan, Tudanan, Kaisapan, Koroloyan, Pitas, and Pisaniban. Pisaniban is the sea level. So it is quite detailed, actually. And each of those have got a function because water itself, when it flows, it gives a direction of from upper to lower river, can become a feng shui punya reference when we want to arrange especially the data. So the head of the corps who want to arrange have to be downstream. If we look at Mount Kinabalu as a reference point for feng shui, the foot will be facing Kinabalu, and the head will be away from there. So we have those kind of feng shui itself. Skip this one because actually this is just talking about the culture is a convergence of divine and human mystery. Okay, the principal deities, once again, we have Kinengan and Sumundu, we have Penempuan, Penempulan, Diwato, which is divinity in humanity, and then the Kamburongo is a consultant helping spirit, the Gimbaran is the ancestral spirit from Pengeluan, then we have the Miantong, the divine dominion ministers. When somebody want to do a ritual to appease Mount Kinabalu, they have to consult all those who are looking after the insects, after the plants, after the reptiles, and then I still remember asking this Lungkita Samansirom, I said, what do you pray actually? So he said, I have to seek forgiveness for those people because some of the climbers maybe they are also naughty, and then they may trample on some things, the plants of the, even the pitcher plants and things like that, and there will be people, the guardians will be, angry with that. So we have to apologize on their behalf ahead of time. What I find interesting within the belief system of the Karajanus is that we have seven spirits in one, seven souls in one. And according to this, this Pinampang Punya Bobohizan, they have certain residence, and they reside in our very senses. That's why when they want to, teach the younger Bobohizans, or the novice Bobohizans, they have to pay particular attention to these residences of the soul. So these are, we have then this Pongito, the seer, the hearer, smeller, taster, locomotor, and then feeler and thinker. But I was asking about the locomotor. How come the legs got soul? Said, how come you can walk while they are sleeping sometimes? So that is the answer for the one. Huh? So anyway, each of these search for a discipline when we want to build in education for the whole Bobohizan. And the same thing, if you want to look at the, from the holistic health point of view, they have to look after all these things in order that a person will be healthy. Similarities means that we are not bad. We have got all those gadgets in. And the levels of beings within us. I was asking a whole old grandpa, I said, how come you people are not afraid when you go and traverse a ways beside all the graveyards and all these things when we are scared? There is a secret to that one, you know, because in them, the formula of the Karajan actually in them is, there is already in them that material, the material aspect of it, then the plants, the animals, the spirit of the, what do you call, the air is with them, and you have the spirits of the ancestors, and then on top of that, they have the divinity in humanity. And when they go from one place to another before they go for mengimbadi, things like that, I remember they said they have to call all his companion together to awaken, then they will travel, even though he is one, but he is traveling in many. Okay, come to Kamatan. What are the cultural functional significance of Kamatan? So here we have, first is Mamulanga, then you have the Magavau, you have the Menang Lumag, Maminadun, and Manugandai. Maminadun is something to do with the honor of Huminadun. So Mamulanga, just now I said it's something to do with repentance, forgiveness, and healing. Magavau, reunion, integration, and communion. Actually, the word Magavau is taken from the word Tavau of the newly scented, the sweet scent of the newly harvested rice. They use it to, you know, to call the other components of the spirit of rice. By the way, the spiritual abode of the spirit of rice, 7-in-1, also in various parts of the plants. Try to see whether it is around here. You see, like human being, the rice itself seems to have 7 components of 7-in-1 components. So they call it, within this whole thing is Sengwas, Sempun, Senrawa, Senggi'i, Senwatu, Semputul, Sembilan. Sembilan is of course smallest particle of the broken rice. And every Bobohizan, every elders in the past will make sure that they take out this. You cannot simply throw it away. They look after all these different parts. And when they considering all these things, no wonder the paddy in the past was very highly well taken care of and they grow very well. Okay, the relationship, because you have so many, after the miraculous transformation, after penempuan became huminadun, then we have the various parts of the body turned into various aspect food for the kadazandasun. So, and the sun is not only rice. And please remember, sometimes when you refer to huminadun transformation, it's not only rice. Huh? But the first rice is the red rice. It still have the of the, what do you call, the blood, and it is the sweet-scented rice, the hill paddy. So this is the renite from which we deduce it from the, how we got it from the deduce that what turned into something. Again, lodun means miraculous transform into new existential reality. So humadun, huminadun, all those have something to do with miracles. Okay, let me conclude this one. Yeah. So as a maginakan, the Kamatan feast, it incorporates the following socio-spiritual aspects. There is an element of reflection, purification, peace and harmony establishment, the sharing, the reunion, the commemoration of redemption, thanksgiving, and renewal. And in relation to Huminadun, the soul of Unduk Ngadawan Kamatan, since it is idolized, as Unduk Ngadaw Kamatan, Huminadun just became the soul of Unduk Ngadaw. And Unduk Ngadaw as Kadayan, manifestation of Penempuan, and Huminadun in Kamatan, thus too became the soul of Kamatan. So Unduk Ngadaw is the soul of Kamatan. Something on Unduk Ngadaw, the term itself, is commemorative term in praise of Huminadun's eternal youth and total beauty of the heart, mind, body, and spirit. This can perhaps be the best reflected in the renites of Babalian Miada Gumarong from Keningau. He said, Binabang kom koserong dilatadaw, koserong de mata kabalangkasan, bitua empinanggornu, nung rangahan pengunduk kesungguh petai tunduk ngadaw, nga isoy kepesedan. I want to explain it this way. You know, there is that Malay saying that when you wet a benang, a string, you can never, you know, you cannot let it stand. But this one is in relation to the uprightness and the goodness of a fellow. Even if you have such kind of element to reach to the zenith, of the highest point of the sun is noon lah. It will not sway, it will still be upright because that is how sturdy and how strong the, you know, the pinanggor, the foundation of the beauty of the heart, mind, and body of Huminadun. From Pinampang, there is another term. Where is that one? Where is that one? They say that Unduk Ngadau has such the radiance of a beauty that if her eye of the bowl meets the eye of the bowl of the sun would be the one to shame to drop. That means it's more powerful than the sun. So this is just what you call a comparative way of saying. So in other words, kau unduk datadau awinanus. So if you refer to someone, oh, kau unduk datadau awinanus, no, means there is no more for the beauty beyond that. Okay, because we are talking about the way forwards, these are my reflections. What are the roles, the vital roles and functions and responsibilities undertaken by Penempuan for the world? And what are the virtuous attributes of Huminadun worthy of emulating by Onuk Adaus do this? We are in a world of distress, actually. We all know that something is wrong somewhere. And if Huminadun were alive today, as Kinaingan's daughter, you must remember, she has performed her role, function, responsibilities as goddess of peace, mercy, and love to perfection. As Penempuan is the savior of the world, both from destruction of sin, physical famine, and as savior, Penempuan brought the Kadayans back home to Kinaingan. As Bambarayan, the rice soul, Huminadun has provided for the nourishment of both the Kadayans' body, mind, and spirit. And with her mystical body and blood in red rice, the Kadayans can receive Holy Communion and gain strength, especially to fight against the penempulan turned Dragon Gaya, evil Amis and Kelungkut. Huminadun in Bambarayan has made manifest these virtues, self-realizing, self-determining, self-preserving, self-generating, self-integrating, self-profusing, self-purifying. Also, within the rice concept, they have all these names within the Rinite: Ohinapod, Ohinamod, Otiru, Odan, Ompidot, Olikambang, and Olinod. And within the symbol of Kamatan, the Toguruan, there is always that bunch of rice and with a little bit of bag underneath the black one. Those inside those symbolic objects, inside that bag are symbolic objects. A bit of a paddy bun miniature, gagamas, then pangasaan, salunsug, dokuton, pinusupusu, nrilibu. Pieces of this. Again, attributes of Onuk Adau. As divine mother of all the Balungkitas, Huminadun bestowed mammalian faith upon the first Babalians, teaching them the languages, the dances, the deities, about the deities, the divinities through the Rinites, and ascending them to the level of enlightenment called Rundukan, or Sians. It is by choice that they go to Sians level, that's why they can return. So you not disturb them, because if they don't return, means they can die, actually. So sometimes they say, do not take photograph with flash while they are Rundukan. I don't know, I've never tested that really when they say cannot do. So as Sunduans and Bambarayans within physical senses, Penempuan has made manifest the perfect harmonization and integration of unity in divinity and unity and humanity in divinity. This is the Koduduo, the Koduduo, your lifetime companion, Nicholas Sampapas just now, and then that's why we have to refer to that as seven in one, because even when we die, if part of those are remaining on earth, then they can still be causing disturbance because they want to get attention that they are left behind. One of the greatest tragic incidents of our time is actually the one in, in Keningau itu, Typhoon Greg. According to the Bobohisan, there has never been so much cries looking for, you know, destinies of the soul. Okay, let me go. So I think for the future, if it is true that Huminadun is the soul of Unduk Ngadau, then it's also true that Unduk Ngadau today has to face an evolutionary life within a revolutionary world. So she has to deal with the downfall of the world of the Kadazans and all the calamities that we are facing at the moment. You know that we are in a world in distress in various degrees. And there are lamentations. I'll just read this one. Man has come a long, long way to master his universe and have ultimately to repay the price. You think about those that are being trafficked, all these things, kan? They have dissected my brains, stripped me of my personhood. They have sensationalized and intellectualized the reasons to justify their actions. I do not know who I am anymore. I cannot communicate my anguish. I can only manifest them. And I'm afraid to look deeper sometimes because I'll know who I really am. So lost in the steaming millions, and I'm all alone, and I'm wide in the sea, and yet there is no water to drink to soothe my burning thirst. Is there no way out? Where do I end? Where do I begin? Give me the strength of your company, O Huminadun. Let's say these are the calls for the Huminadun at the moment for your contribution to a better world. And there may be a new dawn, the light to clear. And I cannot but must say that we have the mission, something to the call of the prayer of Saint Assisi here, because in a world where so much peace is needed, Unduk Ngadau has to be the channel of peace, has to be a channel to must bring hope, must bring light, must give faith to those in hopeless, and must console, and must love with all the soul. So, for those people who are familiar with St. Francis Assisi, I think this to me capture the mission, continuing mission of the Unduk Ngadau, to be the channel of peace, love, hope, and faith. So with that, I want to thank you for your patience.